nous allons évoquer
we're going to discuss mental maps and education for sustainable development.
Alors,
what is
mentale,
a mental maps?
Let
us start there. A mental maps is made up of a number of elements, words, drawings, signs, constituting a graphic representation of a thought, an object, or a problem. This graphic representation has qualities, but also limitations. The first upside is the fact that it is easily read. The second quality is that it functions in a way similar to the way our brain functions by associations of ideas. There are several ways to refer to those objects, several words, and we will use the term mental map. The mental map is compared with a different type of tool, the linear document or text, which is useful when you want to provide information on your thought and provide information. But if you need to spot one specific piece of information quickly, then a text is not the best way. Whereas a map is very efficient for that purpose. Maps must be made, and I'll explain about that in a second, but first I would like to explain how they should be read and analyzed. Reading and analyzing maps. Once the map has been drawn up, so we have a representation called mental map, someone's representation of the object sustainable development is made of words which are distributed in space. There's a dual analysis, a graphical analysis and a semantic analysis. The semantic analysis is based on the subject being studied, in this case sustainable development,
and
we can try and spot the various categories of sustainable development, environment, social economy, etc. And in the map, we can spot whether one category is more often referred to and how, because this will give us an idea on how the person who made the map sees the object. The graphic representation is also focused on the spatial distribution of objects. Here we start from the simplest representation, solar, and then move towards more complex representations where there are more interactions. This is what we call a system, and there are intermediate states. The objects, once they have been read and qualified, will be better understood, and we can start understanding how to use them. Something else that I would like to say about mental maps and the way they should be read. Mental maps are very similar to cognitive activity. There are intercategory links between words which belong to different categories.
Once
we have read and analyzed the map, we can then understand how to use the maps in the project of education for sustainable development. Each map will obviously meet a very specific aim. Either we want to provide, to finalize a thought, and that means we make a map for ourselves, or we write a text for ourselves, or we want to serve a collective project. And in that case, the tool should be something that will allow players to determine priorities, hierarchize information, and then organize themselves in time and space. Let me remind you that the Education for Sustainable Development has a number of objects which are very interesting. The final aim is to question the connection that we are developing with the various objects around us in the environment, places, times, or living beings.
Et dans ces cadres-là, ces liens sont renouvelés. Ce lien est renouvelé. Aujourd'hui, les crises sont nombreuses.
Today we know that there have been many different crises, very diverse crises, and the human species, mankind, must question its position versus the surrounding world. Maps will be made with several aims in mind, one of which is to imagine what would be the representations, the social representations or initial representations of one person or a group of people on a given subject. For instance, you can place one word at right in the center of a sheet of paper, and this is the word that will trigger everything else, and all the other concepts will be added that have been initiated by this word. This is what I showed you at the beginning of my slideshow. And it gives a very good idea of the way a given person envisages the subject. Another way to use those maps is to use them with a specific software called Freeplane, but there are other similar softwares that distribute the words on the screen
à la fois rendre compte de manière assez rapide,
whereby one will see on the screen very quickly which objects have been studied during a meeting, for instance, but also showing the hierarchies that have been decided. Now, digital supports, digital formats are interesting because the object can be shared, can be used in more ways than just a piece of paper. This is a different procedure. Finally, as a conclusion, the map as an object should be considered as something which is both written but also which is a picture. When we start talking about writing, it refers to language, and I believe it's quite interesting to question our connection with language, the way we choose words, the way we use words in projects, and in order to address different problems. Mental maps. We believe that mental maps are a good tool that will make sustainable development education projects more efficient.
Pour rendre plus efficaces les projets d'éducation au développement durable.